Penguin Random House Audio presents Please, Sorry, Thanks, the three words that change everything. This is the author, Mark Batterson. To my mom and dad, who taught me to say please, sorry, and thanks. Introduction. Abracadabra. In the beginning was the Word, John 1:1. According to linguists, abracadabra is the most universally used word that doesn't need translation. It's a word employed by magicians, but the etymology is more spiritual than magical. The ancient words abracadabra mean, as I speak, I shall create. In other words, words create worlds. Words, said the Jewish theologian Abraham Heschel, are themselves sacred, God's tool for creating the universe, and our tools for bringing holiness or evil into the world. In a series of studies conducted at the University of Chicago, the recordings of thousands of counseling sessions were analyzed. Some sessions were successful, resulting in sustained change. Others were unsuccessful. The differentiating factor? It wasn't the therapist's technique. The difference, said Dr. Eugene Gendlin, is how the counselees talk. Life is a grand game of Simon Says and you're Simon. If you want to change your life, you have to change your words. Our words don't represent the world objectively. Rather, our words create the world subjectively. For better or for worse, our words can function as self-fulfilling prophecies. They have the power to bless or to curse, to heal or to hurt, to give life or to cause death. Scientific studies have found that negative words spoken to plants cause them to languish, while positive words help them flourish. It's as true of people as it is of plants. The tongue, said Solomon, has the power of life and death. The Jewish sage, Aquila the translator, defined the tongue as a tool having a knife on one end and a spoon on the other. Death or life. The tongue is a two-edged sword. With the tongue, we praise our Lord and Father, said James, the half-brother of Jesus, and with it we curse human beings who have been made in God's image. He likened the tongue to a rudder of a ship which determines its direction. Your destiny, to a large degree, is a derivative of your words. Out of the overflow of the heart, Jesus said, the mouth speaks. Words are like X-rays, but they do more than reveal the condition of our hearts. Our words are both a diagnosis and a prognosis. Dr. John Gottman is famous for his ability to predict divorce with more than 90% accuracy. How? He examines language in thin slices and analyzes the way people argue. In doing so, Dr. Gottman identified negative communication patterns that he called the four horsemen of the apocalypse: criticism, contempt, defensiveness, and stonewalling. If you want to change your relationships, you have to change your words. Can I make a confession? The political polarization of recent years has taken a toll on my life and leadership. Low levels of civility, coupled with high levels of cynicism, have created the perfect storm. It feels like no matter what you say, it's never enough and it's always too much. Or is that just me? You're damned if you do, damned if you don't. Positivity is one of my strengths, but I recently found myself in a funk. Here's a journal entry from one of those down days when I felt like I was emotionally flatlining. I'm so spent. I'm so tired. It feels like I'm running on empty. I'm just not bouncing back. My head is foggy. My heart is irritated. Lord, help me. I did a lot of self-examination during that season, and one revelation was that I was using negative words with a high degree of frequency. You know what I realized? I was speaking negativity into existence and giving it power. By emphasizing how hard leadership was during that season, I was making it harder than it had to be. My words became a self-fulfilling prophecy that reinforced a vicious cycle of negativity. The same thing happens when you complain about people behind their backs, which was a second revelation. Want to change that dynamic? You flip the script by catching people doing things right, then bragging about them behind their backs. If you want to change your attitude, you have to change your words. Your words are like Occam's razor. Simple words can solve seemingly impossible problems. Your words are Archimedes' lever. Small words can make a world of difference. This book is about three small yet powerful words: please, sorry, and thanks. Often referred to as magic words, they can work wonders. Nothing opens doors like please. Nothing mends fences like sorry. Nothing builds bridges like thanks. These three words have the power to change your life. They have the power to change the lives of those who love you, those who hate you, and everyone in between. In the pages that follow, we'll explore the psychology of please, the science of sorry, and the theology of thanks. Along the way, we'll learn the art of empathy. We'll cultivate emotional intelligence and contextual intelligence. And I'll cite stories and studies, along with some best practices that will help you change your life by changing your words. But first, a word from our sponsor, and I mean that literally. To understand the power of words, we must go back to the very beginning. God said, "Let there be light." According to Leonard Bernstein, winner of 7 Emmys and 16 Grammys, a better translation than said is sang. In the beginning was the note, and the note was with God, said the former conductor of the New York Philharmonic. And whosoever can reach for that note, reach high, and bring it back to us on earth, to our earthly ears, he is a composer. On that note, pun intended, every atom in the universe sings a unique song. In more scientific terms, every atom emits and absorbs energy at a unique frequency. It's true of every element in the periodic table, it's true of you, and it's true of words. Life-giving words resonate with that original note. Destructive words do the opposite. They cause internal dissonance because they're at odds with God's good, pleasing, and perfect will. Few words resonate with more power than please, sorry, and thanks. They sing in three-part harmony. A pretty please opens hearts and minds and doors. A simple sorry can mend broken relationships. A heartfelt thanks is the flywheel of gratitude. There is an art and science to all three words. We'll wordsmith please, sorry, and thanks, approaching them as an art form. But let me start with science. Whether God said or sang those first words, let there be light, we tend to think in terms of phonics. But sound is first and foremost a form of energy. So really, we should think physics. Our words don't just exchange ideas, they exchange energy. The human voice produces sound waves that travel through space at 1,125 feet per second. The average female speaks at a frequency of 170 to 220 hertz. The average male, after puberty, speaks at a lower pitch of 100 to 150 hertz. Mariah Carey is famous for her 5-octave range, but the rest of us have a vocal range between roughly 55 and 880 hertz. We also have a range of hearing between 20 and 20,000 hertz. Anything below 20 hertz is infrasonic. Anything above 20,000 hertz is ultrasonic. This is when and where and how sound does strange and mysterious things. Infrasound is how elephants predict changes in weather and how birds navigate as they migrate. ultrasound can be used to track submarines, guide non-invasive surgery, clean jewelry, heal damaged tissue, break up kidney stones, and reveal the gender of a baby via sonogram. Does God speak audibly? Absolutely, but that's a thin slice of his vocal range. His ability to speak is way beyond our ability.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.